Hey guys! In the teardown video, I didn't describe exactly how this gear train works, but it's actually one of the most interesting parts of this camera. So in today's video, I'm going to talk a little bit more about this. As you can see, I've already taken some of the parts out, and that's because I want to show you this gear. This gear is actually very, very useful. It interacts with four different parts, and I'm going to show you how. The first thing that happens in a picture taking cycle is that this edge pushes this lever arm radially outwards. And as it does that, this rotates about this screw and the hook releases the other lever arm. And the second lever arm releases the shutter, just like this. As this gear continues to rotate, it actually pulls this ejector arm up. And this pushes the film out of the machine. This gear also loads the shutter by pushing this second lever arm down, just like this. And now we're back to where we started. On the bottom side of the gear, you can see that there is this profile. As the gear rotates clockwise, or anti-clockwise if I flip it, this profile pushes this or this up. As it rotates more, the leading edge pushes this pin out to the front. And this is how the shutter is loaded. And as we have already seen, the front side profile pushes this radially outward, and that releases the shutter. I've now put the gear back into position. There's actually a second profile that runs along the inner radius of the gear. And this cutout actually interacts with this lever arm that is placed on top of it. And I think this is what happens. When the gear turns until this cutout is around this position, it releases this lever arm so this lever arm can back out from the switch. And when the contact switch is not pressed, it signals the PCB that it is now ready for the next picture. So we can see that what's going to happen next very quickly is that this gear will release the shutter. The design is actually very elegant and interesting. It is very hard to describe everything in a video. I hope this gives you a little bit more insight on how this works. Let me know down in the comments if you have any other questions. So the second part of the video is to show you how to put this back together. So this close-up view will hopefully show you more clearly how to put those springs and the lever arm together. And you can test that it's functional by doing this. And before you put the gear back in, you need to release the shutter and also push this right to the top. And hopefully you should be able to turn the gear by 360 degrees without any problem. And if you didn't bring the ejector arm up before you install the gear, there's a chance that this profile lies above these two protrusions, and it will not work. In this case, it would be jammed. I think there's just one more tricky part that you need to know to put this camera back together. For the button, there should be one sheet metal part like this. And you should put it like this before you put the actual plastic button on. The rest of the part should be quite straightforward. I hope this video helps.